Molly, patting and pitching, right in her mother's kitchen. Again I have to lose out, someone blew a fuse out. What can you do in the dark?
How old are you?
Tell me how about you, babe? Will you be my new babe? My brand new favorite brunette?
The kind of man that I demand must have a lot at his command.
I'll learn a lot of parlor tricks and get advice from Dorothy Dix.
And will you buy me diamond rings and little $1,000 things?
I'll give you lots of Cadillacs to go with every pair of slacks.
Well, let me know when you get there. Then you'll be my favorite brunette.
The home of all the best hits from the 30s, 40s, and 50s. Those of you out there fighting our battles and working for the betterment of the wasteland, this song's for you.
Laughs at a few things don't mean a thing upon the street of dreams. Dreams broken into can be made like new on the street of dreams. Gold, silver and gold, all you can hold is in the moon. For no one's good long as love is sure on the street of dreams.
Love laughs at a king, cause kings don't mean a thing on the street of dreams.
Motherfucker.
Dreams that's all broken in two. You can make them just like me on the street of dreams. Now you take gold, silver and gold. All that you can hold is way up yonder in the moon. Oh, ain't nobody bold. Long as love is sure on that old street of dreams.
Lord, locks out of tears. Things don't mean a thing on the street of dreams. Dreams broken in peace can be made like me on the street of dreams.
I'd like to go see Chet and do some shopping while we're here.
Gold, silver and gold, all you can hold is in the moon. Gold, no one is old, long as love is sure.
A kiss is still a kiss. The sigh is just a song. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. future brings as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers. This time goes by. Moonlight and love songs never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by.
Radio, the home of all the best hits from the 30s, 40s, and 50s. Well, here's some interesting news for you folks. Apparently the steady flow of ghouls that's been attacking the town of Novak has stopped. How about that? Good things do happen in Wasteland.
Hey! day I'm getting more popular. So you need magic words that will see you through. When you ain't got no gold and you don't know what to do, say it now. Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Well, hey.
Motherfucker.
You looking to buy some supplies? Give me a shout if you need anything else.
Hi, how you doing today? Here's my list. What have you got for me? I'm ready. Let's go.
We'll sip a little glass of wine.
Why ain't you? Ah, forget it. Is that thing supposed to be? No. What's up? It's just a little bike trouble, you know. No biggie. I don't know. The rear stabilizer is kind of loose. Well, that shouldn't cause any real problems. God knows. It could be anything. Oh, magic. Well, come on then. I guess we gotta find a gas station then, don't we? Yeah, we. You know, like, you and me. You dig? Hey, I knew I could count on you, pal. So, where are we heading? Okay, lead the way.
One time, when I was out exploring with one of my brothers, we found some pre-war dog toys. A couple of them still squeak.
So this is the... But where do I put the... Huh. Are you sure this is the right place? Right, yeah, gas station, yeah. You know, man, I don't think they're open. Well, I'm all out of ideas. Hey, do you want to go for a drink? I saw this place when I was riding down on the I-15. I wanted to check it out. Come on, it ain't far. Let's go. Say, man, what did I say? I told you this place would be good. What's your drink, pal? Hey, go on. Get that down here. Yeah, I like this place. Sometimes, you just need to wind down, you know. Before I leave, I'm gonna come back here one night. Watch the sunset. The name's Nina. I'm kind of a drifter, you know. Where else? I'm on my way to Vegas. Really? Well, ain't that a coinkydinks? Anyway, enough about me. What do they call you? Nah, I don't like it. It's too hard to remember. So, what do your friends call you? Well, you're probably gonna need one with, you know, a name like that. Gimme what? That's my name, man. Come on, throw me a bone. People don't call you anything else. Niner ain't a number. It's asking questions. We're on to you now. Six. Yeah, that works. Okay, six. Back to business. What are we gonna do about my bag? I doubt it around here. These people don't even got shoes. We'll have to check at Prim. Isn't that just up the road? Okay, let's just head back to my bike then. I've got to pick up some stuff.
Radio, the home of all the best hits from the 30s, 40s, and 50s. Remember, folks, just because you're in the Mojave doesn't mean there's no radiation. Carry a Geiger counter with you at all times, and make sure you've got some Radaway or Radex in your pockets, too. We don't want you getting crispy fried. You know, some folks think that the apocalypse was God's punishment for the sins of mankind. Personally, I think it was the result of a couple of idiots getting really upset at each other over nothing. Here's a tip.
Come on! Stupid except us. Am I right, Six? Am I right? What the hell, man? Don't go acting like it was your fault, okay? I need something to take the edge off. Steady, man. Why are you after it? Your loss. Oh, yeah. That's the stuff. You know what, man? It was a shitty bike. Always letting me down. I don't need it. See, all I need is you, Six. You see, me and you, we're gonna make it to Vegas. Even if we gotta walk there. Am I right? What'd you say, Six? Great. Hey, we are gonna be the best of pals, I can already tell. Okay, let's make our way to Prim then. Nah, man. Backcountry, I'm telling you. I rode down that way. Almost got raped by giant lizards. I had to spend 3 days hiding in some tower. So they got bored and wandered off. Nah, cause I got a little, you know, busyness to take care of on the way anyway. Let's just head south, swinging east past Nipton, back on the road. North, we'll be there in like 3 or 4 days, tops. Lead the way, man. Yeah. More questions? Okay. Go for it. I'll be honest with you. I ain't much of a marksman. I'm more of a skirmisher, you know? I'm pretty handy with a shotgun. Or an SMG. Anything that keeps me light in my feet and at the front of the fight. If things get up close and personal, I can hold my own. Just don't expect me to be taking out power armored goons with a bat. Nah, not really, man. Blunt and efficient, it's the way to be. We're gonna get along just fine, you know that. I was a breaker in my old gang, you know. I've always been fast on my feet, and I know how to throw enemies off their game. I'll set him up and you knock him down, eh, pal? Ain't too sure where I was born, but I spent most of my life in California. It's safe enough, I guess. I grew up in a town run by the NCR. Most kids just wanted to be soldiers. They see the guards with the uniforms, and the way people respected them. We all looked up to them, you know? I guess I had a pretty cozy life compared to most kids out there. Nah, man, I hated it. Just being kept like that. It made me feel uneasy. Lots of reasons. Most of my friends, they went off to the NCR training camps when they were still young. Some became farmers. See, that's what the average kid in California can look forward to. Being a soldier, or being the guy who feeds the soldiers. I decided to leave when I was still young. I doubt anybody even noticed. Come on, man, I ain't gonna talk about that. Yeah, it just ain't right. You know, people deciding how your life's gonna turn out for you. And they wanna raise future bullet sponges. Trouble is, this one opened his eyes. Okay, see ya.
Play radio. The home of all the best.
Hey, Six, can we stop at the Mojave Outpost? I got a little something to take care of. You know, it won't take long.
I've been asked in the past.
Alright, let's go.
The answer is that I love them all, except the ones I don't. Here's one I do love.
Big mistake, friend. Don't touch Mr. Killingsworth.
host, Blake. You ever wonder what exactly it is that keeps us going, even through the mess that is the wasteland? Me too. Here's a song while you cogitate.
First recon to Camp Forlorn.
Now we've got a chance.
Got a chance to hold it.
got you now.
Six, can I borrow a smoke? I'm all out.
A word to the wise. Upsetting one member of the faction is upsetting the whole faction. Don't shoot someone unless you're prepared for every one of his friends to shoot back at you. You know, folks, I knew a guy once. Had a real love for him. He's dead now. Say no to drugs. Here's a song.
I'd like a large atomic shake and a double Brahmin burger. And easy on the agave sauce this time.
We gave you a password, Veronica. It's for your safety.
I know where you live, Ramos. Open up.
For Pete's sake, opening up. Welcome back, Veronica.
Yeah. Listen up. I'm in charge of security around here, and I can't say I'm too happy about having an outsider waltzing around. But since you came in with Veronica, I'm inclined to cut you a little slack. Just behave yourself, and we won't have any problems, okay? Oh, and the Elder's going to want to talk to you. He's on the second level. Just take a right once you get down there. My office is right here in case you need anything. Just ask for Ramos.
But Dom, look at that snake. You're a big and angry fella. Stop!
People think the
it's used to me.
How goes your mission?
We'll know in a second. I wanted to talk to you.
Veronica, tell me this isn't about...
Yes, goddammit, it is. But you're gonna hear me out this time.
We've been through this.
The things I've seen now, other groups succeeding where we fail, it's not too late for us.
We've outlasted the end of the world. We'll outlast this as well.
Waiting in a hole for everyone else to die.
If we must.
This is a dead end for us.
I see no evidence of that, nor do I see anyone out there with a solution to our problems.
How could you? You're too scared to look. Let's go. We're wasting our time.
When you first came here, I'll admit, I didn't know what to expect. But after giving the matter some thought, I believe an outsider would be of great help to us. I will not force you to help us. Should you refuse, you will be granted access to leave this complex. There is much the Brotherhood can offer. What do you say, outsider? Are you willing to help us? Then allow me to explain our situation. This bunker is currently locked down, allowing no entry or exit, you being one of the very few exceptions. In exceptional cases, teams are sent out to investigate sites or to retrieve materials deemed too important to ignore. Three such teams have gone missing. Up until now, we haven't disclosed this information. I need you to find out what's happened with those three patrols. I'm glad I can count on you. Oh, and one other thing. The patrols each had a holotape. These holotapes had information regarding their mission, and you can use these to track them. The shielding of the bunker prevents us from actively tracking them, but the position should show on your map once you reach the surface. Should our worst fears become realized, please bring me each of the holotapes from all three patrols. Otherwise, bring our brothers home. I've given the order that you be given access to some of our equipment. You still won't be able to purchase any prohibited equipment, but hopefully some of what's available will prove useful for you.
So, you're the outsider that's been given leave to wander around freely. Desperate times call for desperate measures, I guess. Name's Harden. I'm the head paladin of this chapter, and I think we might be able to help each other out. I don't know what the Elder talked to you about, but I can tell you this chapter is in trouble, and he's at the center of it. Are you willing to listen to what I have to say? Why should you trust the Elder? I'd recommend listening to both of us and choosing whom to trust for yourself. So are you willing to listen? As you may have already heard, this entire base is under a state of lockdown. No one goes out except small patrols at night. Most of the chapter has been sealed in here for years, and those few who were outside when the lockdown was initiated are forbidden from returning. Morale has plummeted as time has gone by, and many of our current paladins haven't seen combat outside of training simulations, and all because of the Elder's explicit order that no one be allowed in or out. The only way things will change is if a new Elder is installed. Veronica's a special case. She handles the procurement of supplies. If we didn't let her and those like her back in, we'd all starve. If the Elder could manage it, he'd shut them out as well. And all in the name of security. Which is why we need to replace him. Of course I have, many times in fact. The Elder has an open door policy and will listen to advice on any subject save this one. He refuses to see that our isolation is slowly weakening us. Aside from being our duty, going out on missions is what kept us strong. And because he fails to see that, he must be replaced. I half expected you to say that. In which case, I'll continue to pursue the matter on my own. Should you continue dealing with the Elder and find yourself beginning to see my point of view, I'll be around.
I'd slap him around, but he stood at my parents' wedding. Plus, he used to make excuses to get me out of my punishment when I'd slept through Head Scribe Taggart's lectures. Figure I owe him for that. He means well. No, but it does make it easier to forgive him. He's just misguided. It's not too late to change his mind. He's a stubborn old man, but when it comes down to it, he's got our best interests at heart. If he sees some indisputable sign we're on the wrong course, he won't ignore it. I don't know. We need something that shows the Brotherhood will fail, or that it can do better a different way. The only thing that gets its attention is technology. Huh. Maybe Father Elijah had the right idea. Our elder before McNamara, he had a nose for recovering lost technology. He'd send scribes out into the desert chasing whatever leads he found. There were a few he only trusted me with. I can think of at least one that'd prove my point, if it still exists. There's a comm terminal not too far from here I'd use to access messages from him. If we go there, I can pull up his research on it. That's my question to the Elder. All these years, the Brotherhood has collected weapons technology. And for what? To keep it out of people's hands? That clearly hasn't worked. To defend ourselves? We can't compete with the NCR's numbers or the Legion's. We're fighting a war for a lost cause. If we're gonna survive, we have to find a role in society, attract new members. Look at the followers of the Apocalypse. They use their expertise to improve people's lives. They train them to be self-sufficient. That expertise cultivates respect and gratitude, spreads their ideals, draws talent to their cause. They make friends like we make enemies. But they don't know a fraction of what we know. If we took on their role, we could stand up to anyone. We wouldn't have to hide. I'm with you. Being around here isn't the same anymore.
What is this? Veronica brings an outsider into our home, then has a private audience with the Elder? The two of you may have the Elder fooled, but we know better. Veronica has always twisted the Founder's principles to her own ends. We will not stand idly by and allow her to corrupt our Elder's thinking.
Pardon?
Veronica.
Sorry about that. Just because I love them doesn't mean some of them aren't assholes.
Folks, this is Blake, and you're listening to Wave Radio, the one thing in the Mojave that won't try and kill you. You should always